Hi students, we are going to discuss about some compounds under haloalkanes and halorines. These are all very important compounds which has wide applications in the industry. So you need to prepare for this answers very well. The first compound is DDT. DDT is dichlorodiphenyltrichloroethane. So these will be groups will be attached in the para position of the phenyl group. So it is called PP dash dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane. DDT, the main important use is it is used as pesticide and insecticide. So this compound is chloral. What is chloral? Chloral is trichloroacetaldehyde. You know what is acetaldehyde? Acetaldehyde is CH3CHO. Here, instead of three hydrogen atoms, you have three chlorine atoms. So it is called trichloroacetaldehyde. So it is, the name is chloral. For trichloroacetaldehyde is chloral. And this compound is chlorobenzene. To the benzene ring, I have written it in a flat way. To the benzene ring, chlorine atom is attached. It is called chlorobenzene. Here the hydrogen at the para position of the chlorine atom is protruded out in order to explain the formation of water. Two molecules of chlorobenzene is taken. And along with chloral, it condenses to form DDT. So here, how the water molecule is formed? The CHO group, aldehyde group of chloral, that oxygen will combine with the two hydrogen atom, which is at the para position of the chlorine atom in the benzene ring, to form one water molecule. So altogether, you form, you get a condensed product, CCl3CH, and with the two chlorobenzene groups. Altogether, hence it is termed as these are the para positions with respect to this position. So para dash, dichloro, diphenyl, trichloro, and two carbon atom is ethane. So trichloroethane, that is the name for DDT. Its important uses, it is used as pesticide and insecticide. And the next compound is preparation of freon 12. Freons are chlorofluorohydrocarbons. Freon 12 particularly is prepared by Swartz reaction. How, why it is termed as freon 12 is given in your textbook. You may see the explanation for that. And Swartz reaction is the reaction between carbon tetrachloride and hydrogen fluoride in the presence of antimony. Antimony is Sb. Antimony pentachloride to form freon 12. So here carbon tetrachloride is CCl4, hydrogen fluoride is HF to form freon 12, that is CCl2F2. Here the four chlorine atoms, out of the four chlorine atoms, two chlorine atoms are substituted by two fluorine atoms from hydrogen fluoride. Fluorine is more reactive, so the substitution is very common. So CCl2F2 freon 12 is formed. The substitution can be limited in the by the presence of the catalyst antimony pentachloride. So freon 12 is formed, the byproduct is 2HCl. So what is the use of freon 12? It is used as a refrigerant in refrigerators and air conditioners. It is used as a propellant, that is to give the throw of the aerosols, foams, deodorants and insecticide, shaving creams, etc. It is used as a propellant. So two important use, refrigerant and propellant. Okay, your next compound is going to be preparation of chloropicrin. What is chloropicrin? Chloropicrin is trichloronitromethane. So let us see the structure of chloropicrin. It is given here. Just see, trichloronitromethane. NO2 group is totally called as nitro. Three chlorine atoms or trichloro. Trichloronitromethane. Why methane? Because one carbon is present. Instead of CH4, the four hydrogen atoms, three chlorine atoms are present instead of three hydrogen atom, and one nitro group is present instead of one hydrogen atom. So altogether it is actually methane, where the four hydrogen atoms are substituted by chlorine atom and nitro group. So it is termed as trichloronitromethane. So here chloroform CHCl3 is treated with nitric acid. When it is heated, it forms trichloronitromethane. Look at the structure of CHCl3. CHCl3, H is displaced by NO2 group. That is only chloropicrin. So CCl3 is there. Instead of H, you have NO2 group. That is the only difference. And this H will react. Here HNO3 can be written as HONO2. So it is a supplier of NO2 group. This HO combines with H to form water. So CCl3NO2 chloropicrin is formed. Chloropicrin is a soil sterilizing agent. It is used to sterilize soil. Like how your stomach is dewormed by having a syrup like that. Soil is sterilized by chloropicrin. So trichloronitromethane, it is used as an insecticide and soil sterilizing agent. And then next fourth compound is preparation of chloroform. Chloroform is CHCl3. You have heard about chloroform. It is used as a preservative and it is also used as an anesthetic. Nowadays it is not used. So how this chloroform is prepared? The formula for chloroform is CHCl3. That is the formula for chloroform. CHCl3. How it is prepared? So the easy way, you can write this word equation if you want to get half of the mark. Ethyl alcohol, when treated with bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is actually CaOCl2 1H2O, calcium oxychloride monohydrate is bleaching powder. But when dissolved in with more water, it will form, it is a source, it acts as a source for chlorine and calcium hydroxide. The product will be chloroform and the byproduct will be HCl. The byproduct is HCl. And the next one, it is taking place in three steps. First, the ethyl alcohol, CH3CH2OH is ethyl alcohol, is treated with chlorine. It acts as an oxidizing agent. So CH2OH, the primary alcohol group, is converted to CHO, removal of hydrogen. So CH3CH2OH becomes CHO, which is acetaldehyde. And the byproduct is HCl. And next, this acetaldehyde further gets chlorinated with the excess of chlorine, and this three hydrogen atom, it undergoes substitution. Now it is called a chlorination. Three hydrogen atoms are removed. The alpha hydrogen atoms are substituted by three chlorine atoms. So altogether you get CCl3CHO, chloral. Chloral is trichloroacetaldehyde plus HCl is the byproduct. And this chloral, the third step, undergoes hydrolysis. In the presence of hydrolysis can be done in the presence of an acid, a base, or just water. Here, a weak base, that is calcium hydroxide. In the presence of the weak base, the trichloroacetaldehyde is, chloral is hydrolyzed to form chloroform, and the byproduct is calcium formate, chloroform. CHCl3 is the formula. So this alone, this reaction, I mean, the preparation of chloroform alone takes place in three steps. Okay. So what are the three steps? Oxidation, chlorination, and hydrolysis. Hope you understood the concepts very well. You can get any one of the compound in your exam. So prepare well for the exam. All the best, students.